G'day guys, back again. Hope you're doing well. Now, this will surprise you maybe a little bit, like my Tamir car that I did just a couple of videos ago, but rally car. I do like a couple of different, is it genres or I don't know. I'm a bit eclectic, guys, in my model collecting. I was on Facebook the other day and I saw a bit of a rumour, or I don't know, some people get cranky if I call it a rumour, that Wingnut Wings were closing down. And I've got it on Facebook and I've seen a couple of people have sent or, you know, snapshotted pictures, letters or whatever, correspondence saying that they are closing down. And then I've also had people say to me that I know that they've rung the actual suppliers or even spoken to the people sort of semi in charge of Wingnut Wings. And they said that, you know, not to worry, they're still going to be having kits, or whether that's, you know, the kits they've already done making those. So not to worry about, they're not all going to disappear or dry up, or whether they've got a whole lot in their warehouses that they haven't put out yet, I don't know. So I've heard that story as well. So I'm not sure which one's true, which one's not true. But because of the whole schmozzle that's going on, I thought, well, I've always wanted a Wingnut Wings kit, and I've never really... I've always seen them at shows and I've seen them at swap meets and I've never picked one up. And so after hearing this, I thought, well, now's the time. So I went and picked one up for myself. And of course, guys, you know I like figures. So the first one I picked up, it had to have a figure in it, didn't it? For a figure that comes with a kit, this little fella looks like a really nice looking sculpted figure. So I had to pick this up, and I won't lie to you guys. The other reason is that I've looked at some of the Wingnut Wings instructions on some kits, you know, with their I don't know what, their triplanes and the ones with all the wires that are going everywhere. And I thought, you know what, that will just destroy me trying to build one of those kits. Because I'm not really a huge aircraft modeler, as you can tell by my channel. But I really wanted one, A, for a little piece of history, because you guys know I like models. And I've always wanted Wingnut Wings. Even though I may never build it, I don't know, it's just a little piece of history. And especially if they do close down, I thought I'll be kicking myself if I don't pick one of these things up. So as you can tell, I picked up a pretty, I'm hoping, one of the easiest kits to build, because it's only got, you know, one, do you say one wing or two wings? You know, that's how much I know about aircraft, you know. One on each side, you could say, and it comes with a figure. And I thought, you know what, this is the kit for me. So I'm not going to go through the whole kit, guys. I just like showing some of you guys on my channel some of the things I pick up. But to be quite honest, I actually did buy this kit half for the figure and half for the plane, because I did like the figure as well. So getting the two in the combo, I just had to buy it. As far as I'm concerned, for someone who likes figures, and a figure that actually come in a kit, I think it's actually quite a nice figure, and it's sculpted really well. The fur around the collar is nicely done. One thing that always makes the figure a lot nicer is if the hands are sculpted nicely, and these hands are sculpted nicely, and hopefully you can see there's lots of nice little creases on the sleeves of his arms there. Now that looks a little bit odd, guys, but the head sits in there, and I'm guessing it's semi in focus, and I think it's a really nicely sculpted head with the goggles from what I can see, because I haven't primed it. And I'm very happy with this figure. I was hoping it would be a nice figure, but I kind of wasn't expecting it. So I'm very happy with that figure. So I'm sure there's lots of reviews on this kit out there if you're interested. I just like showing some of the guys that actually watch my channel what I pick up. So here are the decals here. Now, as you know, if you don't know anything about Wingnut Wings, I'm not going to go into the detail of it all, but you can do your own little bit of researching. But obviously the guys that makes these planes, absolutely, all these model kits, absolutely love aeroplanes, because they put so much effort into these kits. And the thing that made me happy about this kit, guys, I'm not going to lie to you, I picked this kit because when I looked at the parts, all the sprues, I thought, yeah, there's just not enough there to make me happy. Or does that make sense? There is enough, there's just enough there to make me happy, not too much. So I thought I could probably build this one. Look, I could build, you know what I'm saying? I could build a dragon kit, you know, with 27 million parts, but I'd prefer to build a Tamir kit. I do build dragon kits. I'm building the Stug at the moment. I think it's the F/8 Stug, the Winter Stug. I really love that kit. I really like it. But some of the earlier Dragon Tiger kits, I think, you know, they have so many different versions that when you open up the page, it's like, you know, there's six versions of a part that you need. It just drove me crazy. So I sort of put that Tiger kit back in its box. But anyway, I digress. I'm just going to flick through these instruction guides. The other thing I heard about these, and this is probably one of the things that scared me off these kits for a long time, and you see it a lot, people sort of say, if you prime your kit and you paint your parts first, they may not fit together on these kits, because they say the fit on these is so precise that with the layer of primer and the layer of paint on it, it may be too thick. And I thought, jeez, that's getting a bit cray-cray. So that sort of scared me off the kits for a long time, which is also why I've picked a kit with small part count, so I don't have to worry about that too much. And knowing me, you know, I'll do my own paint color or scheme or whatever it is on this, or, you know, something. But I'll pick the easiest one, guys. That's what I'm trying to say. And again, I don't think they go to town too much on the PE. But even that there, you know, guys, I've got to confess to you, I'm not a huge PE lover. Look, I love your screens, you know, your flat screens, and I love the pre-molded. Sometimes in some kits, they actually do the pre-molded thing over a template for you for one of your PE things, and I like that. I'm not a big fan of getting out, you know, your etch set and doing a Z and a W and a back and a forth and a turn around and wrap it around a piece of pole and then pull it out sort of trick on your PE, because I just don't really find that enjoyable. But, you know, look at this. This paint scheme's pretty... This one here is a lot easier, isn't it? Well, they're both pretty similar, so... I should be okay with these paint schemes, guys. Don't fret. Don't fret. I think I'll be okay. But, jeez, I mean, come on. I mean, look at these kits. I mean, look at the deep... Even on the figure. I mean, you don't... Even in figure kits, you don't get this much detail on just a standard, you know, standalone figure kit. They don't do this. But hopefully, they'll show up for you there. Here's a nice-looking figure. A little bit over here of the details of the guys here, and I'd just like to say thank you very much, guys. I've always loved these kits. I've always loved looking at them. I've been tempted to buy so many of these kits over the time, but I'm really glad I've picked one up now. I knew it would have been Mike Good. I was going to say, I wonder if Mike Good sculpted the figure, and lo and behold, it was Mike Good. G'day, Mike. Jeez, you're good. You are good, mate. And there's the back there. Now, guys, as I'm not a huge, and as I've said before, I'm sure there'll be reviews online on these things. I'm just going to go through with them in the kit. Just a quick look at the parts. That's interesting. You seem to get two propellers there. Like this. So expect that. Just another sprue shot. Now, this is looking like my type of kit. Very little part count on this little fella. Why do you even need PE? Look at that. I mean, maybe is that an option to have PE and not have PE? I don't know, but I'm hoping it is, because I do love when a model company does that, when they give you the option of doing a PE version and not a PE version. I'll be very happy if that's the case. Very happy indeed. And nice, you get your little clear parts. And here's your last sprue here. And that's going to be a pretty decent sized kit when it comes out, actually. It's not a Bandai 172 Star Wars kit, guys. No, it's not. This is actually has some decent length on it. What's this? This is up around your 18 centimeter mark. Anyway, guys, as I do, that was a very unprofessional review of my first Wingnut Wings kit, which I'm delighted to have. And I really do hope the whole company doesn't close down and the kit's still being produced, because I think one of my mates was very excited about, you know, the new big Fandangle. Oh, I should know what it is now. You know, the big bomber that they were coming out and they were sort of talking about for ages. And I hope they haven't stopped halfway in the middle of that. It's not going to happen. That would be a real shame. Well, hopefully it gets sold off to, I don't know what it is. Is it the B-17 or something? I don't know which one it was. But hopefully it gets sold off to someone else, or it gets developed or finished off, because I know a lot of people were really excited about that kit. But anyway, guys, that was my very unprofessional view of a Wingnut Wings kit. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.